What's going on, guys? Big Deuce 12 here, coming at you with the first ever GameCube video and first ever Star Wars Rogue Leader, Rogue Squadron 2. GameCube is a system I played a lot as a kid. It's really near and dear to my heart, honestly. So I got an Elgato. My room looks like a complete mess with all the wires going on.
The Death Star will soon be in
place. And yeah, and I always wanted to capture gameplay for the GameCube. So why not start it off with, you know, Star Wars Rogue Squadron? Something that, a good Star Wars game that I want to play. Not, you know, the Star Wars Battlefront 2 stuff. I wish EA would do what Factor 5 did. So anyway, just the main objective of this video series, I just want to play through the story mode and play through the game. There's some missions that are, you can only unlock if you gain enough points through meadows after you complete each mission, but I don't really want to focus on those missions. I just want to play through the main game. So without further ado, a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Honestly, I did not want to, like, read you guys the wall of text. Experience that for yourselves. It's like a Star Wars movie. Enjoy.
All wings report in.
Red 10 standing by.
Red 7 standing by.
Red 3 standing by.
Red 6 standing by.
Red 9 standing by.
Red 2 standing by.
Red 11 standing by.
Red 5 standing by.
Lock S spoils an attack.
A scene right from the movie. Of course it's graphics, it's like GameCube graphics, it's not from the movie, you know, whatever.
Watch yourself. There's a lot of fire coming from the right side of that deflection tower.
I copy, Red Leader.
We've got to destroy those deflection towers.
Red Leader, we've got you covered. I'm going after the towers, cover me.
So first part, we gotta destroy these deflection towers, as they just said. The cool thing, though, about Rogue Squadron series is that I have...
Follow me.
So all these missions in this game are in spacecraft. X-Wing, Y-Wing, A-Wing, B-Wing, you know, so on and so forth. I think that's all of them. I don't know if there's any mission in Millennium Falcon or not. But I get to control my two wingmen, who are Wedge and Biggs. So they can form, like they are right now. They can attack the guns, or they can flee. And I don't really get the fleeing part, because you would probably want them always next to you or doing something.
Great shot.
So I don't really see the point of trying to get them to flee.
Shot, Luke.
Two more to go. One more to go.
Yeah, the color in some of these, I don't know if it's just my TV kind of looking at the computer screen where the Elgato is recording. It looks a lot brighter on there than it does on the TV, so...
We've picked up a new group of signals. Enemy fighters coming your way.
Biggs, Wedge, follow me. So now a fourth option opened up, and it's attacked the TIE fighters, and the your Weemen AI, I know for this mission, and if I remember correctly, the next mission after this, it's been a while since I played this game, so I believe it... The AI is really good. It's just future missions down the road, if I'm remembering correctly, where the AI doesn't really do anything. They don't really attack anything, even if you tell them to. I think that's programming issues. See, I have to like hold down the Y button on the GameCube controller and, you know, press A to fire. I just think it's kind of a hassle. But, you know, whatever, it's GameCube. There we go.
Good shot, Luke!
Okay, where are they at? Without me trying to fly around in circles. Oh, there they are.
Two more to go. One more to go. Got him!
There we go, that was easy.
Get ready for your attack run.
Now it's our turn to make the attack.
Biggs, Wedge, let's close it up.
Right with you, Luke.
We'll stay back far enough to cover you.
Whoa. Yeah, see, well, I don't understand what they're staying back from, because it's like, they're not really destroying the guns, and I can't command them. I'm pressing on the D-pad on the controller, and nothing's popping up, so. I just don't want to hit any barriers or anything like that while trying to be in this trench. Ooh, okay. Let's not go too fast.
I'm hit. I can't stay with you.
Hurry up, Luke.
And see, the cool thing about this, like, these aren't... None of these are Darth Vader's, of course, because he has the advanced one. But TIE Fighters, I can just, like, kind of go... around them in a way, just hang back and just attack them, just blow them out of the sky. That's what I remember doing as a kid numerous times. There we go.
Is strong with this one.
Ah, Vader.
Use the Force, Luke.
Yeah, can we hurry this up a little bit? I'm getting shot up by Vader.
His computer's off. Luke, you switched off your targeting computer. What's wrong?
Nothing, I'm all right.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
You're all clear, kid. Now let's blow this thing and go home.
Thanks. Thank you. Thank you, Han. After her, I just got gunned down. But thank you for coming to the rescue. I appreciate it 100%. And I gotta play catch up a little bit. Alright, you see that small circle right there? That's where I'm aiming at. There we go. I always get scared that I'm like gonna crash right into it. I'm like, oh no. But nope, got it. Not even a medal. Oh man, dude, I'm so rusty in this game. It's been years since I played it. Anyway, guys, that's gonna be the end of this part one. If you guys like the video, make sure you guys give it a like. If not subscribed, make sure you subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next Star Wars Rogue Squadron Rogue Leader. Rogue Squadron 2 Rogue Leader. Excuse me, that's such too many words. And this is the start of the GameCube era on my channel. See you guys later.